So, you have murdered me after all. But what good will that do you? The shroud isn't here.
You sought a tool of healing in order to extend your own power.
Not mine, ours. You are so short-sighted. You'd hoard power and never use it, when we would better the condition of humanity. I hope you never find the shroud. You have no idea what it truly can do.
Tell me then.
No.
Thank you. Take this down. Then I want it sealed until you receive further orders. Miss Thorne. You supplied me with the means to secure London's future. The city thanks you. The Order thanks you. I thank you. But the Shroud can only be worn by one. Therefore, I hereby dissolve this partnership. I promise to endow you with an income into your old age. That is the most I can do. May the Father of Understanding guide you. Yes, what is it?
Miss Thorne, sir.
What of her?
I'm sorry, sir. She is dead.
And the key? Where is the key?
There was no key found on her body, sir.
The Shroud will be mine, even if I have to raise hellfire to do it. Burn the letter.
Go. Ah, my young friend. How good it is to see you. Fortunate, really. It would appear a highly toxic plant, which has the extraordinary effect of making people quite delirious, has been found in this very park. Yet, as far as modern science is aware, no such plant exists.
Not your average flower. Mr. Darwin was right about these plants. Oh, I don't feel well. One less to worry about. Footprints must belong to a rogue gardener.
put you in your cup.
Mr. Darwin will want to inspect these flowers.
Here now. Mr. Darwin will want to inspect these flowers.
Come on!
Well done. But you don't seem quite like yourself, if I may say so. It's just as I suspected. Those noxious fumes are not being released from the flowers, but from the pots. There must be something in there. An hallucinogenic concoction of some kind. Not unlike the soothing syrup, I should think. We must dispose of it, and quickly. I believe, my young friend, that I might know just the place. Who would want to poison the population of London? Who could devise such a nefarious plan? Obviously, it can't be Dr. Elliot's. So who can it be?
An organization my brother and I have been fighting all our lives. Dr. Elliotson was one of them.
I don't need to know more if you do not care to tell me. However, may I be so bold as to suggest that you continue to fight them?
Of course, Mr. Duff. Come on! Faster!
I'm afraid, my young friend, that some of your enemies want their toxin returned to them. I suggest you position our carriage directly in front of theirs. I believe the fumes will impair their ability to drive. Indeed. Well, I'd better run now. You will take good care of yourself, won't you?